This young man has superpowers. But Juwon's power is strange. He can replace the superheroes. About 20 years ago, some people with superpowers appeared on Earth and caused chaos in the world. Conventional weapons became almost useless against them. Those who used their powers without following the law and pursuing their interests were called criminals. And some others who stood for justice and fought them were called heroes. Among the heroes, the most famous one was Justice. He opened up the world of heroes, where people wearing tight clothes and masks ran around the streets. Although he also wanted to wear red underwear outside once. Juwon's superpower did not allow that. His superpower only allowed him to copy the appearance of someone else. And obviously he could not fight the criminals with just his face. But luckily, this superpower could be used to make a living. Many heroes came and signed contracts with Juwon. He was almost fully booked for the whole month and earned a decent amount of money. Today, after finishing his work, Juwon returned home and lay down on the bed dreaming of a beautiful life after retiring at the age of 50. At that moment, the knock on the door that changed his life completely rang out. Juwon opened the door and almost had a heart attack from shock. The person standing in front of him was Justice, the most famous hero. As soon as he saw Juwon, Justice said, "You are Lee Juwon. You are committing a crime by impersonating the heroes living in their normal lives, aren't you?" Juwon was gaping in astonishment, feeling extremely anxious. "Justice, he knows. So he came here to arrest me. Should I run away? But how can I run when my opponent is Justice?" Juwon was so scared that he almost wet his pants when Justice suddenly spoke. "I came here just to hire you to transform into me and live my everyday life like the other heroes." Juwon heard that and woke up, pointing his finger and asking. "He hired me, but for what?" Justice answered seriously. "I know you and you shouldn't ask personal questions. I brought everything you need." Justice put down a valet on the ground that contained all his necessary information. Juwon looked at it and reminded him gently that he couldn't work without a picture of Justice's face in the documents. Justice didn't hesitate and took off his mask, revealing his true face. This was the first time someone knew Justice's real identity. If this was revealed to the world, it would cause a huge shock. But Juwon knew that he had to keep his job confidential or he would die. After reviewing all the documents, Juwon accepted the job and asked about the time and place. Justice put on his mask again and told Juwon to come to the address on the card tomorrow. Juwon didn't have time to say anything else before the other person jumped out and disappeared into the dark night. He held the card in his hand and had a bad feeling about this. The next day, Juwon arrived at the address on the card. Standing under the skyscraper, Juwon could only gape in awe. He didn't know how long he had to work to enjoy things like this. Then, Juwon entered the building with a nervous mood. Justice, the leader who protected the people in the city, and he had to impersonate him. And he didn't understand why he hired him, but he couldn't let go of a big fish like him. If he did well, he could extend this job for a long time. Juwon went straight into the room that was assigned to him. He saw a luxurious apartment and Justice was sitting in the middle of the room. Juwon tried to act calm and pulled out the contract from his bag. "All right, let's get to work. First, here are some terms and conditions, please fill them in." But the scene before his eyes terrified him to the core. Justice, the strongest hero, was covered in blood, sitting still without moving. Juwon was scared to the point of wetting his pants, his head in chaos. Was he dead, the number one hero? But who did this? He had to calm down, maybe he was still alive. With that hope, Juwon reached out to shake Justice's body. But as soon as he touched him, suddenly many bright blue beams of light appeared. These beams of light pierced through Juwon's body and then pushed the two of them apart. Juwon was shot to the ground, his mind dizzy. He still didn't have time to recover and see what the hell had just happened, when he suddenly discovered that his arm had changed. Juwon screamed in horror, his mood at this moment was extremely panicked. But at this time, what did he know was the most important thing? Juwon looked at the cold corpse in front of him and then ran away decisively. What was going on? That must have been the energy that flowed into his body, but first he had to get out of here. Although he didn't know what had happened, staying here would only drag him into this mess. He had to report this to the Hero Association quickly. Juwon hugged his transformed arm and flew out of the building. Right at this moment, he bumped into someone and spilled a cup of coffee on him. Juwon was about to apologize when the other party spoke up. "Hey, aren't you the copycat? Why are you here?" Juwon looked closely and it was the hero he had copied the day before, Kim Seung-gu. He seemed angry because he had coffee spilled on him and was about to settle the score with Juwon. Juwon was happy to see a familiar person at this time. "Great, he might be annoying but Kim Seung-gu is still a high-level hero, I need to try some things." Kim Seung-gu saw Juwon always hugging his arm and wondered, why did he hug his arm like that? Ju-won lifted his arm up to explain, but then he realized that everything was back to normal. Kim Seon-gu was furious at this point. He said that was enough. Did he know how much this shirt cost? Even if you could work your whole life, you wouldn't be able to afford it. Just then, they were attracted by some strange noises. And suddenly a drill came from nowhere and pierced a hole in Kim Seon-gu's side. When they realized it, it was too late. A criminal with four drills behind his back had broken the glass and rushed in. The criminal wore a hooded jacket that covered his body, only revealing his weird face. He grinned and said, "Look, isn't this the hero who was on the news? Are you just a kid?" He didn't expect that he recognized the hero's identity of Kim Seon-gu and still dared to target him. Even though he always felt that way, his face turned pale and he was even more terrified. He was a criminal, attacking with drills, wasn't he the one who killed Justice? At this moment, Kim Seon-gu was enraged by being underestimated. He used his power to create a flame that enveloped his body and burned the wound to stop the bleeding. "You bastard, I will turn you into fried octopus." Without thinking much, Kim Seon-gu just rushed forward like an idiot. Before the fierce attack of Kim Seon-gu, the criminal quickly used the drills to pierce the ceiling and pulled himself up into the air. He then immediately used the drills to counterattack. Kim Seon-gu saw that and burst into a fierce flame, repelling the drills away. Then he confidently rushed forward. "You damn octopus, your whole body will be fried." The criminal then smiled wickedly. He had calculated all the attacks beforehand. The drills immediately grabbed Kim Seon-gu and tightened. The number of drills was now much more and they were not afraid of Kim Seon-gu's flame. The weak expressions before were just to make him lose his guard. "Do you think I only have four spoons? How naive." The ordinary people around there panicked and trampled on each other to escape after seeing the hero also defeated. Only Ju-won stood still with his mouth wide open in shock. He couldn't believe that Seon-gu was captured so easily. Kim Seon-gu gave up after struggling for a while. The criminal lost interest and threw him to a corner. Then he switched his target to the ordinary people. He attacked and killed them without mercy. "We are having so much fun, aren't we?" Ju-won was hiding in a corner, hoping that other heroes would come and deal with this criminal. At that moment, his eyes met a flyer with Justice's picture. The people next to him also kept encouraging each other. "Don't worry, this place is under the jurisdiction of Justice, he will come soon." "That's right, Justice will handle him in a few minutes." These people were even more optimistic than the young fans at this time. Only Ju-won knew how desperate the situation was. Justice couldn't come here, which meant everyone here had to die. Waiting for a hero, who couldn't even come here. "But I couldn't do anything either, the opponent was a criminal. He was someone I couldn't beat, I wasn't even a hero." Just as Ju-won was despairing and accepting the cruel reality, suddenly a girl's cry rang out. The killer also shifted his attention to her. Ju-won saw that and ignored his own danger and shouted, "Run, don't sit there anymore, run quickly." But the criminal did not easily let go. He had a wicked smile and used his scythe to approach the girl. "Little mouse, where do you think you can run?" The girl did not know the danger she was about to face and still sat still. Ju-won witnessed this scene and unconsciously remembered the past. His legs automatically stood up and threw himself towards the girl. This feeling of helplessness, Ju-won did not want to experience it again. He rushed forward, using his bare hands to grab the scythe, his mind still spinning in a haze. "Idiot, what am I doing? There is no way I can catch it. It is impossible." At this moment, Ju-won's arm suddenly emitted the blue light from before. His arm transformed and somehow gripped the scythe easily. By the time Ju-won regained his senses, he had activated his power without knowing it. He had turned into the appearance of Justice, but this time there was something strange. Not only his appearance but also his strength had changed. To verify his guess, he pulled lightly and flew the criminal's scythe. The criminal screamed in pain as if he had lost an arm. Ju-won then played the role of Justice and said proudly, "I don't know what's going on here, but under the jurisdiction of the Hero Law Article 1, you will be arrested." Although he had the power of Justice, he was a little worried when facing a real criminal. His whole body was full of strength that he could not control. But this was the first time he dealt with a criminal, could he do it? The criminal was sweating like rain. He tried to calm down and restore the scythe that was torn off. "Don't be too happy, I can regenerate as many scythes as I want. Once you are caught, you will live like that famous hero." He screamed and used all his tentacles to attack Ju-won. But in Ju-won's eyes at this moment, everything was happening very slowly. He didn't need to try hard to dodge the tentacles easily and approach the criminal's face. The criminal didn't have time to understand what was going on and got a punch right in the middle of his face and flew back. But he didn't have time to land before he was grabbed by Ju-won's tentacles and thrown hard into the opposite wall. Ju-won was also amazed by the strength he had in his body. It's crazy, I just pushed lightly but he flew far away. It's amazing. In fact, I still can't control this power, something might happen. While Juwon was overwhelmed by his power, the criminal woke up after being stunned. He knew he had no chance of winning, so he decided to rush up recklessly like a moth to a flame. Juwon saw that and gathered his strength in his fist, ready to send him to see the naked chickens. But when he was most confident, his power ran out. Juwon could no longer feel the energy in his arm, everything seemed to return to normal. Obviously, he couldn't control this change in his body. Everything suddenly became very bad. Now Juwon only had the code of justice but no power at all. If he got hit by this, he would be dead for sure. At that moment, a yellow light suddenly shot out and knocked the criminal away. Juwon was saved by a hair's breadth but still didn't understand what had just happened. His face showed a puzzled expression. It turned out that the owner of the yellow light was a female hero. She came here as soon as she received the news. Luckily, she saved Juwon's life. She arrived and jumped at Juwon and started talking. As expected of Mr. Justice, did you know I would come? After all, you have a great sense of hearing. And you distracted the criminal's attention so I could attack, right? Juwon didn't even know who this person was, she seemed like an unknown hero. He tried to answer briefly to end the conversation. But she admired Justice so much and kept talking. At that moment, the criminal emerged from the rubble and ran away. Before leaving, he fulfilled his duty as a criminal and left some nasty words. Damn, wait for me, I'll be back. But he only ran a few steps before he was killed by the female hero's laser eyes. After killing the criminal, the female hero turned to look for Justice to get his autograph, but he was nowhere to be seen. At that time, another mysterious female hero came. She said, "Don't you see there are many injured people here?" The pink-haired female hero heard that and immediately ran to take care of the wounded. The mysterious female hero looked at Juwon who was trying to escape. She seemed to know something. After returning home, Juwon quickly destroyed all the documents of Justice. He didn't want to get involved in any unnecessary trouble. His hand was still numb from the huge energy source before. He didn't know where it came from and how to control it. After destroying all the documents, Juwon threw them in the trash and took them downstairs as usual. He was very confused and always wondered what to do. What should I do now? Justice was the number one hero, but he was killed by an unknown criminal. The criminal must have been much stronger than him. Because he was too scared, he forgot to transform into someone else to leave. He hoped that no one saw him. Right at that moment, a voice rang out from behind Juwon. I know, Juwon was scared and turned around but saw no one. But the voice continued to echo. You destroyed the evidence with a shredder. You are very careful. Juwon kept looking around to see where the voice came from. Suddenly, a woman emerged from his shadow. She was the mysterious female hero from before. Juwon was so frightened that he fell to the ground, almost wetting his pants. After coming out of the shadow, the mysterious female hero summoned black arms from her shadow and reached for the trash bag that Juwon had just thrown. The arms then tore the trash bag and pieced together the documents perfectly. Juwon was still sitting on the ground, his face stunned by the absurd thing that had just happened. The mysterious female hero read the documents and said, "Now it's clear, you saw Justice die, didn't you? I'm sorry, but you know something you shouldn't." Her whole body emitted a strong killing intent, her shadow expanded and surrounded Juwon. In an instant, Juwon instinctively jumped back and avoided the attack. If he had been a fraction of a second slower, he would have been torn to pieces. He had no other choice, Juwon transformed into Justice and intended to use the power he had received in the morning. To be able to investigate the truth about Justice's death and the origin of this mysterious power, Juwon had to capture the woman in front of him alive. The mysterious female hero saw that Juwon did not obediently die, so she immediately controlled her shadow to attack. The black scythes constantly flew towards Juwon, each one aiming at his weak points. Although he couldn't grasp these scythes, luckily their attack style was similar to the first criminal that Juwon faced. With the power of Justice, he could easily dodge the drills, approach and attack the target. But at the most critical moment, the mysterious energy source suddenly disappeared. Juwon's power gradually lost its effect and returned to normal. At this point, he was just trying his best to avoid the dangerous attacks. The mysterious female hero saw that and sneered. "Ha, in the end, you are just a useless imitator. I wonder who is brave enough to act like Justice. How boring." As soon as she finished speaking, she immediately launched a finishing blow without any hesitation. In the moment of life and death, Juwon did not give up resisting. He used his left arm that still had energy to punch a piece of concrete and use it as a shield to deflect the attack. Then he used all his strength to rush straight forward. His reaction ability was much better than a normal person. The mysterious female hero quickly used the drills to attack Juwon. Juwon used the concrete block to block the attack and then took the opportunity to deliver a full force hook to the jaw. He moved forward as the opponent retreated. She was flustered. "I need to get close to her right now." But suddenly, his body couldn't move anymore. The mysterious female hero also stopped. "You did very well, but it ends here. You see, your body is now in my skill." Juwon was then tied by the shadow. Was this a ninja from the Leaf Village? Juwon used all his strength to struggle, but he was also tied by the drills. The energy source was also completely gone and his body returned to normal. Facing a hero, ordinary people had no chance to resist. Juwon was squeezed by the spoon so tightly that he couldn't breathe, his face turned purple. He couldn't even scream now, let alone escape. The mysterious female hero seemed to notice something after observing for a long time. She waved her hand and all the spoons disappeared. Juwon fell to the ground with a lot of doubts. Why did she let him go? At this time, the female hero spoke. "Do you have any plans for the future?" Juwon tried to stand up and asked back. "What do you mean?" The female hero immediately pinched Juwon's mouth like a puppy. "You don't have to pretend to be someone else anymore, you will have a new future. You will become the replacement for justice. How about it, hero?" Juwon's face turned grim. He didn't understand what this woman was trying to say. The female hero continued. "Justice is the embodiment of all heroes. If the news of his death is announced, it will cause a large-scale panic. But I have found you, a replacement who can extend the time before being discovered." Juwon shouted after hearing this. "Wait, hold on. You just wanted to kill me, why should I listen to you? Who are you really?" Now the female hero introduced herself. "I am Chami, a hero under the command of justice." Seeing that Juwon didn't seem to believe her, Chami continued. "If you don't believe it, you can check it. The documents that justice gave, I also have them." Juwon heard that and rushed to the pile of newly restored documents. Damn, this guy works without looking carefully at the documents the customer gave. After a while of searching, Juwon confirmed that everything Chami said was true. Seeing Juwon gaping in astonishment, Chami explained further. "I'm not at the point of wanting to kill the one who knows about the captain's death, so I just scared you a little bit. Therefore, if you agree to become his replacement, you will receive 100 million a month. As soon as he heard this number, Juwon was so amazed that he couldn't say a word. 100 million, the most expensive thing of mine is not even half of it. Although greedy for money, Juwon was still sober. He understood the danger of this matter and asked again. "But how can I be his replacement? What if I get caught?" Chami immediately reassured. "Don't worry too much, I'll help you prevent that from happening." It sounds tempting, but Juwon didn't want to make a hasty decision and wanted to think carefully. Chami saw that and continued to manipulate his psychology. "I won't force you. But if there is a rumor that justice is dead, the criminals will operate on a large scale. Because the symbol of the hero is no longer alive, the gangs will wage war against the heroes and countless people will die at any time in the war. So think carefully about what the right decision is." Juwon listened and his mood suddenly became confused. "Can I do the things like him? I can't stand seeing innocent people die again." Seeing Juwon hesitate, Chami disappointedly left. "It seems that I have made a request that is too much for him. Enough, I shouldn't have expected anything from him from the start. Just keep Justice's death a secret." At that moment, Juwon spoke up. "Wait, I had some difficulties thinking. When considering the risks, ensuring the work and security stability, 100 million is not enough. At least 200 million, don't you think?" It seems that Juwon has made his decision. He smiled brightly when mentioning the amount of money he wanted to receive. Although he seemed greedy, he understood that if he didn't have a life, what would he do with a lot of money? It all came from Juwon's righteous heart. Chami also knew this and smiled. "Remember not to turn your back on your choice." And so, the substitute hero was born. A week later, Juwon was almost exhausted from reading a pile of documents related to justice. He had memorized the important information and was quite confident that he could cope with the usual situations. At that moment, Chami appeared and announced that they had to go. On the car, Juwon was reading the documents and asked, "Can I ask you a few things? Do we have to hide Justice's death from the other heroes when we fight the criminals? Don't the superiors know about this?" Chami used her power to drive and answered. "Yes, usually that's the case. But to avoid unwanted things, we have to keep it secret. You will know when you see it with your own eyes." After a while, the two also arrived at the place they needed to go. As soon as they arrived, Juwon wondered, that was not the logistics delivery center. "But why are we here?" Chami led Juwon inside and explained. "Yeah, you're right. This is a delivery distribution center if you look from the outside. But in fact, it is the headquarters of the heroes, Archie. Only when Chami showed his identity card to the camera, the huge door opened. The vast space behind the door made Ju-won gape in astonishment. There were countless famous heroes gathered here, and in the middle of the room was a giant gold statue. After passing through a forest of heroes, they arrived in front of a meeting room. Before entering, Chami carefully instructed. "We are here just to observe the situation, so wait here and don't attract anyone's attention." That was where the heroes met. These members were the key heroes of the four hero teams. After instructing, Chami entered the meeting room, while Ju-won stood outside and watched through the door. As soon as it started, the team leader of the Guardians Team 2, Hester, slammed the table loudly. "Why are the criminals becoming more active every day?" The team leader of Uberman Team 1, Ji-young, spoke up. "That's because of some incidents that happened in your area. The number of incidents in other areas did not increase. In fact, for others, the rate of incidents decreased. Aren't you too bad at the job you were assigned? That's because you took some of my staff." And then the verbal fight between the team leaders took place, no one held back anything. Ju-won witnessed this scene and was a bit surprised. Was this really a meeting of the heroes? But it looked strange, it looked like a war. Just when things were tense, the team leader of Ankondo Team 1 spoke up. "More importantly, where is Justice? It's been a week since I saw him." Nivelle sneered, maybe like the rumors that he was dead. Hester slammed his fist on the table, his whole body emitting a killing intent. "Don't think you can say nonsense just because you have a mouth. I won't let it go if you badmouth Justice." Nivelle didn't back down and stood up using his power. "Try it, compared to Justice, you are nothing, do you know that?" Right at that moment, the captain of Union's Team 2, Benji, shouted to stop the chaos. She was like having to watch over big kids. Then, Benji asked Chami if Justice had any contact. Chami calmly answered. "No, he told me he would go for a while but still haven't heard from him." Right at that moment, the captain of Ankondo's Team 2, Pandora, interrupted. "That's a lie. Because I didn't see Justice for a while, I went to his house. And there I saw blood on the floor." The heroes started to gossip when they heard this, while Chami questioned. "Wait, you trespassed Justice's house without permission." "Right now," Russ spoke up. "Chami, is that true?" The space was immediately quiet and all eyes were on Chami. Chami was silent and didn't know what to say, she was very confused at this time. "If she knew the scene, I couldn't lie. If this continues, everything will be exposed." Right at that moment, Justice walked in confidently and cleared the tense atmosphere. "I'm sorry for being absent for too long, I'll explain everything." As soon as they saw Justice, everyone's faces lit up, he truly deserved the title of Hero Number 1. But they didn't know that this Justice was actually just an imposter. The most astonished person at this moment was Chami. What was that idiot doing? Those questions could have stopped, if there was a mistake, he could have blown his cover. But Ju-won was very confident in himself. There were many heroes here with a large scale, although he was very worried, he was quite familiar with deceiving everyone. The stride, the tone of voice and the familiar posture when standing, everything was perfect. Ju-won's efforts of staying up all night for a week were rewarded. He had cosplayed Justice perfectly without revealing any flaws. At this point, Nivelle spoke up, "I don't understand why you are so sudden even though you are late. But please explain to us why your apartment is in that condition and where you have been for a long time." Knowing that everyone knew about the crime scene, Ju-won quickly thought of a reason and spoke up. "There was a conspiracy to assassinate me." All the heroes were shocked and murmured about what they heard. No one dared to believe that it was true, but based on the serious attitude that Ju-won showed, everyone was worried. The most astonished person here was Hester. "What? Why did you keep silent until now? You didn't even tell me." Ju-won still kept calm and continued. "I have to be careful about my actions. Considering the situation, Chami and I had to keep it secret to investigate everything. Although I can't say anything to anyone right now and I also have very few important clues." Seeing that everyone was discussing this issue as expected, Ju-won moved on to the next step. "By the way, Pandora, who allowed you to enter my house?" Ju-won acted so realistically that even a real hero like Pandora felt pressured. She hugged the stuffed animal in her arms and said that she was just worried. Ju-won then held his head and sighed. "Because I didn't expose that plot, the investigation will be more difficult. The culprit will be more careful." Pandora's face was sad and teary. "I'm sorry, I made a mistake." Ju-won scolded seriously. "Your ransom judgment was very disappointing. You were happy that everything went according to plan and the discussion would end here. But nothing is that easy." Ji-young spoke up immediately. "A murder plot against you. I mean something like that. It happened in the middle of the city but no one knew. First of all, we need to check if it was really an assassination. In other words, it was your plan. Ju-won looked confused after hearing that. You don't know what Jiang means. Pandora countered. No, why did Justice lie to us about something like that? Although he could ask, old man Ju-won was about to thank him when Pandora's tone suddenly changed. But you are too good. You care a lot about the people. That is why the criminals are careful and stay away from the areas he often visits. Let's kill them all, or there will be more new criminals and the people will be in more danger. Russ also spoke up in favor of this opinion. He thought that the criminals despised the heroes, so this assassination happened. Ju-won was extremely amazed by the unanimity of the heroes sitting here. Although they had a bad relationship with each other, they all had the same point of view when talking about this. Just when Ju-won didn't know what to do next, Arcadia spoke up. Wait, if justice feels unreasonable, let us know the reason. And more importantly, there is a war going on, we have to go there right now. The atmosphere suddenly became tense and all eyes turned to Ju-won. Then, they all left the meeting and set off. In the car, Ju-won turned back to normal and sighed lightly. He didn't expect that he would have a day when he could talk to so many famous heroes. At this time, Chami threw him a can of water and encouraged him. You did very well. It's surprising that you created such a captivating story. Ju-won felt more comfortable at this time. It's still better than letting them know justice is dead, right? Moreover, why do they have such a great interest in justice? Chami explained, they had been trying to understand each other for a long time. Those who prioritize the safety of the citizens, the protectors. The extremists who aim to eliminate the criminals, and Kondo. Those who follow the doctrine of supremacy and think that the hero is the chosen one, Uberman. Those who hunt for their own interests, Union. These are the groups of heroes that exist, everyone has their own thoughts and goals. After listening, Ju-won also understood the current situation. He wondered about a female hero who was in a hurry then. Chami heard and knew who she was. Haste, the captain of Team 2 of the Protectors, she is a skilled hero. And I bet she is the most loyal to justice. Why do you ask that? Ju-won suddenly became serious when mentioning this issue. When I revealed the assassination plot against justice, although she looked surprised on the outside, her expression was very strange. Because my ability is to copy the appearance of someone else, I am quite sensitive to that small sign. Chami listened and also had some doubts. But since there was no evidence yet, they only stopped at being cautious. At that moment, a tremor suddenly occurred. It seemed that the two had arrived where they needed to go, but Ju-won still didn't understand what was going on. Chami got out of the car and explained. You must have known that the criminals were weaker since justice appeared, right? But since justice disappeared, they had a lot of trouble fighting the criminals. So they wanted to end it through a destructive operation. All the hero groups participated in this. That means justice needs to show up. Ju-won heard about having to show up and fight the criminals and was shocked. Chami continued, after justice appeared, the crime rate decreased. Today we will sweep one of their bases. Four teams will attack from four different directions. You have to be the first one to get to the center of the park. Report back to me with this when you get to the center. Ju-won listened and screamed in horror. Wait, wait. How can I be the one to start the war with the criminals? Above all, I have to be the first one to get there. This is impossible. She said she would support me when there were troubles. But Chami's opinion did not change at all. Do you not want 200 million? I will say it again, justice is the number one hero. If you cannot show good results in a battle like this, then you will be fired afterwards. 200 million is not a small amount of money. So you should work accordingly. There was no other way, Ju-won had to do what Chami said. He took the communication device and turned into justice. Thanks to the power of money, which boosted his strength, Ju-won jumped down the cliff without hesitation and headed straight to the center. The scene before his eyes was crazy. The whole city was engulfed in fire. The skyscrapers were destroyed by the power of the heroes and the criminals. Bloody battles took place everywhere, kill or be killed. But it seemed that the battle was leaning towards the heroes and Ju-won did not need to intervene at all. That was because the number of heroes deployed this time was extremely large. Ju-won was standing and observing the situation when he was spotted by a female hero. She was the one who saved him before. It was nice to see you again. I heard you were killed by someone. Who spread such a rumor? She was a passionate fan of justice. When they were talking, a criminal suddenly attacked from behind. The female hero had not yet put on her helmet to fight, but Ju-won had already solved it with a punch. Although he still could not control this energy, it seemed that everything would be fine if he did not use his full power. Ju-won then asked and learned that this female hero's name was Haste. He said goodbye to Haste and quickly headed towards the central area. On the way, the criminals kept rushing to the road but they were all killed by Ju-won in a flash. The power of the number one hero was truly terrifying. Having this power in his hand made Ju-won remember the past. When his sister was in the hands of a criminal, he could not do anything. He did not know how he could copy the ability of a dead hero. But if he had this power before, Su-na and his family would have been different. At that moment, Chami's voice brought Ju-won back to reality. Are you okay? If you go too slow, you will be left behind. Ju-won immediately increased his speed and moved forward. He silently vowed to use this power to help those in danger. The criminals on the way now only saw Ju-won's back. But they seemed to have no intention of stopping him anymore because there was a very strong one ahead. In no time, the park appeared in front of Ju-won's eyes. At this rate, he would be the first one to arrive. But nothing in the world was easy like that. A pine tree suddenly flew to block Ju-won's path. A large criminal slowly walked towards him. Oh, justice came to visit me? What an honor. Chami only relied on the voice through the radio to recognize the identity of the criminal. Don't tell me that's Ksenia. He's a famous name among the criminals. He's the one who goes around killing heroes just for fun. He has killed dozens of heroes and civilians. He is too strong, you are not his match. Run away, don't fight him. Ju-won decided to listen and not do anything stupid after hearing this. He quickly circled around the criminal and headed towards the park. But Kasser did not easily let go of an opponent like that. He stomped his foot on the ground, and a circle of encirclement suddenly appeared. Ju-won suddenly became heavy and was grabbed by the neck and thrown away. Kasser was pleased at this moment. If you want to escape, you will surely lose. Because you are in the two-person arena fence. Ju-won also felt something abnormal with his body when he was in here. No wonder, his body became much heavier. His strength could reduce the strength of others, he had no choice left. Although he could not control and maintain his strength perfectly, watch this. Ju-won then gathered his strength in his fist and rushed to attack. Kasser did not dodge at all. He used his hand to block the attack directly without any injury. Too weak, your strength seems to have been reduced significantly. He immediately used his spear to counterattack. Ju-won quickly backed away but still got hit in the shoulder. He had not yet reacted when he ate another stab in the stomach. Although he used his hand to block it, the spear tip pierced quite deep and the wound started to bleed. Kasser was pleased to see that. Seriously, this is all you have, justice? I don't understand why they are scared every time they hear your name. You need to try harder to fight against me. Ju-won was blown away and fell into a difficult situation. If we use all our strength, we can win easily. But if we use all our strength, we might revert back to how we were before. If we don't control it, our power can run out at any time. At that moment, Ju-won suddenly felt a huge surge of energy. Kasser became more confident when he saw his opponent had no reaction. Don't look down on me anymore, use all your power. As long as I can kill you, the heroes will stop their actions, I will pierce through you. He put all his strength into his spear and rushed forward crazily. But his attacks were blocked by Ju-won with one hand. His whole body emitted a massive stream of power that made Kasser suffocate. Superpowers are like a glass of water, the more you use, the closer the water level gets to the bottom. But Justice's ability is not a cup, instead it is a vast ocean. Ju-won possessed such a huge power, but he didn't know and suppressed it. Now he just needed to unleash it, just one punch was enough to knock Kasser away. Luckily he had a helmet to protect him, otherwise his face would be smashed. On the other side, Hester was silently waiting in the room when her assistant came to ask. Why do you feel so restless and worried? Hester looked anxious because Justice hadn't signaled that he had arrived yet. The assistant wasn't too worried. Dia, he's slower than usual, maybe he met Kasser on the way. Hester couldn't sit still and wait anymore, she stood up and looked out the window. If something like that happened, then he had been fighting for too long. I have to go there and check. Back to Ju-won's side, he had unleashed his full potential after awakening. Kasser was punched into a pig's head and had no resistance. Now he felt the fear of fighting with the top one server. What had happened, he seemed to have become a different person. Ju-won's whole body was now emitting a huge stream of power. Before, he had always tried to control himself when using all his power, which led to overload. But now he used this power freely, so everything was different. Ju-won did not waste words with Kasser, but went straight to punch him into dust. Kasser tried to block the punches with his spear, but his speed was far behind and he kept getting hit. Damn, he was too strong. No, I can't accept it. If a barrier in the arena couldn't stop him, then I would end this with two barriers. Kasser stomped on the ground again, and a circular barrier was created. Ju-won's speed was reduced and Kasser was able to counterattack. Kasser smiled smugly. He decided to end the match with the next spear strike. But in front of absolute power, all tricks were meaningless. Ju-won did not dodge, but used his fist to smash the spear that was heading towards him. Kasser witnessed this scene and was terrified. No way, this couldn't happen. How could the difference between his and my power be so great? While he was stunned, Juwon's fist lightly touched his face. Kasar was hit and immediately flew away, landing headfirst on the ground and losing consciousness. The barrier also disappeared along with it. Juwon only dared to breathe a sigh of relief at this moment. This was still very risky. If I use too much power, I might lose it. It seems that I have to train more if I want to fully master this power. At that moment, a building suddenly exploded from afar and attracted Juwon's attention. They were the heroes from the Ankondo group, just like what I heard. They didn't care about the surroundings when fighting the criminals. Juwon was calmly watching the battle when he suddenly got hit by a stray bullet. A building was hit by the battle and was about to collapse on Juwon's head. Hey, isn't this too much? I have to get out of here quickly. At this time, he noticed the criminal who was unconscious and started to hesitate. If I leave him behind, he will surely die, he has lost his ability to defend himself. What should I do? Why am I thinking about this? He tried to kill me. Whether he lives or dies is up to him, not my business. Even though I tried to anger myself like that, at the last moment, Juwon still picked up the criminal and ran. As he ran, he complained. I'm crazy. When you wake up, you have to repent for your actions and live a good life, you hear me? But because I wasted too much time thinking, Juwon couldn't get out of the building's range in time. A whole skyscraper was falling down on him and Juwon had no choice but to close his eyes and brace himself. But strangely, he waited and waited, but Juwon didn't feel anything touch him. When he opened his eyes, he saw Chami standing in front of him using his power to hold up the whole building. I told you I would support you. In an instant, the whole pile of rubble was pushed out. He was truly a professional hero, unlike someone else. Juwon sighed, because I thought I was dead just now. But Chami was not very happy and was angry. You helped a criminal. Have you lost your mind? Juwon was helping Kasar up and awkwardly explained. Well, as a hero, you should not let anyone die, right? This is not something that justice usually does. At that moment, Kasar woke up from his coma. He immediately broke free from Juwon's hand and rushed towards Chami. He pressed a piece of metal against Chami's neck and threatened. I can't be dragged away like an animal. In this situation, Chami was still very calm. Look, this is what you get for saving a criminal. The position of justice is not something that you can protect with such an irresponsible attitude. Whether alive or dead, Kasar cannot be forgiven. He is the leader of all the criminals here. Letting him escape will pose a danger to justice's identity. Kasar did not understand what the hell was going on and pressed the metal piece closer and shouted. What are you guys mumbling about? I will really kill you. Juwon could feel that Kasar was not lying, he would really do it. He calmly told him to stop and slowly backed away to create a sense of safety. Kasar felt that his goal was about to be achieved and was pleased, finally you understood what was going on. But as soon as he let his guard down, he was immediately grabbed by Juwon and slammed his head into the wall with lightning speed. After all, this guy was just a brainless criminal. After confirming that he had dealt with the criminal, Juwon turned back and said to Chami. I have cleaned up the mess that I caused. Chami just sighed. Yeah, you sure know how to talk. But it's too late now, send the signal to them. Juwon then remembered his mission when he came here. He used the radio to contact the others and report. This is Justice, on behalf of the hero, I am at the target location. Thinking about the 200 million he had just earned, Juwon happily smiled. I, the number one hero, earned 200 million so easily, haha. Chami stood next to him and looked at him with contempt. She was thinking about another more important issue. He was quite eccentric but he had very good skills. Even when he had the power of justice, he could not beat me with those skills. That meant his skills had improved in a short period of time. I only knew he was a lunatic when it came to money, but I guess I could expect more from him. Juwon was now worried that the criminal he had just beaten might die. After all, he was a good citizen who had never killed anyone. Meanwhile, Haste was quietly watching everything from the roof of a nearby building. Her eyes were full of suspicion. At that moment, the radio transmitted a message. Haste, Justice just sent a signal. Haste calmly replied after hearing it, oh, okay, I have confirmed it myself. Although it took some time to find a good observation spot, behind Haste was a long line of bloody corpses. It seemed that she had just caught a bunch of criminals here. It was really scary. After completing the mission, Juwon and Chami left. On the way, Juwon kept sighing in a depressed way. Chami saw that and asked, what's wrong with that lifeless face? Juwon then complained, I think I will die of exhaustion. I mean, it's great to be able to maintain this change by not holding it back anymore, but it's too exhausting. I think I have to find another way to control it. Chami then encouraged Juwon, anyway, you have used the power of justice. I think it's very interesting. Ju-won immediately blushed and felt embarrassed after hearing these words. What's going on? Why is she suddenly so beautiful? Cha-mi then asked Ju-won if he had tried it after the first time. Ju-won did not hide anything and shared his second experience. Oh, that thing, if I touch the corpse of a person with abilities, maybe I can absorb their power like I did with Justice. This is worth trying. When I touched the corpse of a criminal, I had a reaction to it but I couldn't absorb the power. It felt like something was blocking it. Cha-mi thought after hearing that. Maybe you can only absorb one source of power, or the power of Justice is too big. This issue is currently hard to conclude. Ju-won's power is a mystery and needs time to figure out. The thing to do now is to focus on celebrating the recent victory. At the hero headquarters, a big party was organized. It was easy to see the huge influence of the number one hero Justice. Contrary to the cheerful scene of the party, Nivelle was outside and complained to Ji-young. Damn, they are really useless. They are very happy after winning. And what are you going to do? Ji-young turned away coldly and left. I'm not like them. I don't like having fun. Nivelle saw that and asked curiously. Do you have a plan? Ji-young turned his head and smiled mysteriously. I don't know. Instead of calling it a plan, it would be more accurate to say that their smiles will disappear by themselves. The next day, the alarm clock in Justice's luxurious apartment woke up Ju-won. He felt like he was about to die because he drank too much last night. Yeah, my head feels like it's going to explode. The beer drinking ability of the heroes is admirable. Anyway, I have to stay in Justice's house for a long time. Ju-won only had time to look around this place after he woke up. It was worthy of the name, Number One Hero. This place was very high class and luxurious. Ju-won never dreamed that he would have a day to live in such a place. After walking around the room, Ju-won nervously checked his phone. The amount of 200 million was transferred to his account. Ju-won smiled happily in a mean way. He finally got the money of his dreams. The elders were right, the more power, the more money. But then Ju-won immediately changed his attitude after realizing the harsh truth. This would not end even if I got the money. Justice was assassinated. The autopsy report of Justice that Cha-mi gave me said there were no external injuries. But he was not poisoned either. The only thing was, he had gone crazy using his power. What happened that day? Just as Ju-won was focusing on the report, there was a sound of opening the door. Ju-won thought it was Cha-mi, so he casually said, "You came at the right time. I'm looking at the autopsy report you gave me." But as soon as Ju-won turned his head, he saw it was Haste. He was startled and hid under the seat. No way? That was Haste. Why did he come here? And why did he come here like it was normal? Haste then approached and spoke. "Justice, I just heard your voice here. What are you doing down there?" Luckily, Ju-won had turned into Justice and started to push up with one hand. "I'm just training a bit." Haste saw that and was excited. "Wow, training the day after the party. That's Justice for you." Ju-won tried to stay calm and act as naturally as possible. There was nothing to be surprised about. But why did she come here without telling me? Luckily, Ju-won had time to throw the pile of reports under the seat. If Haste saw them, everything would fall apart. Haste answered seriously when asked. Oh, he said there was an assassination attempt targeting him. This was not the first time. He needed to talk about this with everyone. Ju-won now understood the strange expression of Haste in the previous meeting. So that was the reason why she was not surprised at that time. It makes sense, if she knew so many things, she would not be surprised much. At that moment, Haste hugged Ju-won and blushed shyly. He was so mean for not telling me anything. The warm breast pressed against him made Ju-won very astonished. He was confused and didn't understand what was going on. Haste continued. He said he would call me John Gunn when it was just the two of us, right? Ju-won heard that and sweated profusely, gaping in shock. Don't tell me these two are in a secret relationship. But I don't have that information in the file. No way, did he hide it from me? Seeing the other party not saying anything, Haste coaxed. Hey, are you not going to say anything? Ju-won hesitated for a while and then said embarrassedly. Sorry John Gunn, I guess I'm not used to calling you by that name. Because I'm used to the way of calling when working. Haste suddenly paused and then continued to act cute. Oh, I see, I was very annoyed when I was called that. Ju-won thought he had escaped, he finally could breathe lightly. But Haste's face was friendly but her hand had pulled out the sword from the sheath. She did not hesitate and swung the sword to take Ju-won's life. Ju-won reacted in time and avoided the fatal blow by a hair's breadth. Just a fraction of a second slower and his head would have been severed from his neck. Haste's eyes were full of killing intent, her hand gripping the sword as if wanting to kill someone. I almost thought you were Justice for real. The sword stroke just now was so terrifying that the table behind Ju-won was hit, but still maintained its shape for a few seconds before falling apart. Haste then threw the sword sheath in her hand and went into a fighting stance. All right, before I ask any more questions, let me start by cutting off one or two of your arms. Haste was the deputy of the protectors, led by Justice. Her ability was super speed. Haste used supersonic speed to rush straight forward. She cut everything on the way. Ju-won had to try hard to avoid a few fatal blows. He looked at the scene in front of him and was shocked. She cut everything like cutting tofu. Even though he knew she had fast speed, the sword was very sharp. Haste still had no intention of stopping. She looked at Ju-won with eyes full of killing intent and rushed up to attack again. Ju-won had no other way but to gather his strength on his two arms and block the attack. Hey, wait, I told you to stop. The blade of Haste's sword cut into Ju-won's hand like cutting into a piece of steel but still left a wound. She did not blindly attack again but retreated to keep a distance. You look like Justice but you don't know how to control that power, huh? You are truly a professional hero? You can tell the condition of your opponent with just a few moves. Ju-won was very confused and did not know what to do. She was right, luckily I still have my hand. But I'm still injured and more importantly, I can't control this state for long. If so, I have to fight fast and win fast. Ju-won rushed straight ahead and attacked with all his strength. He knew that the person he was facing was not simple. Just a little careless and he would go see naked chickens. But Ju-won's attack was easily dodged by Haste. I don't know how you defeated Kasser, by brute force? But what good is that identity for you? As she spoke, she avoided Ju-won's attacks as if playing. When Ju-won showed weakness, Haste would give him a slash. I advise you to stop using your power half-heartedly to block my attacks. Because if I want, I can slash you anytime. So listen to me, it won't hurt much. But of course, Ju-won would not wait for death. He was always in a defensive position ready for the next attack. If you were in my situation, you would know, Haste was now possessed by killing intent. She had no intention of listening to any explanation. With lightning speed, Haste rushed straight towards Ju-won and stabbed him with her sword. It seemed that the fight was over but Ju-won had calculated it. He took this opportunity to grab Haste's hand and hit her hard in the face. But Ju-won immediately realized that he had just messed up. Huh, I'm not sure but I think I just pissed her off. Haste's blood rushed to her brain and she glared at Ju-won. How dare you do that while impersonating Justice? Ju-won immediately felt bad about this and needed to rush at her when he had a chance. But before he could react, Haste had disappeared. In an instant, Haste appeared behind Ju-won. I give you two choices, lose one or two arms. Ju-won had not said anything yet when Haste disappeared again. Next was countless powerful attacks from all directions. This unbelievable speed made Ju-won unable to do anything but just passively take the blows. When he felt it was when the sword was about to cut off his arm. It was too late to react now. Was this the moment when Justice with red hair was born? At this moment, the black tentacles appeared to block Haste's sword. Justice had not yet recovered, sweating profusely. Luckily, Chami arrived in time or he would have joined the disabled club. She was still a lunatic when it came to Justice, huh? Haste, although he had withdrawn his hand, still kept a resolute attitude. I understand, you are also an accomplice. Explain to me what is going on. Remember, your shadow can't stop me. There was no other way, Chami had to tell the truth. Justice was killed. After calmly listening to the story, Haste could not control his emotions, his voice trembling and asking again. You mean Justice is dead and he is playing his role as a substitute? Ju-won had also changed back to his original shape, his body full of wounds. He sat still and did not dare to say anything for fear of losing his head. Chami then continued, we have no choice left. We can hide the truth for a while. As soon as she heard this, Haste shouted excitedly, do you know what you are doing? Even if he can use Justice's power, he is too careless. And how long do you think this drama will last? He will be caught when his identity is exposed. Haste is now very agitated and confused, unlike her usual image. She always spoke up, who killed Justice? And why? We need more time to investigate, but Haste immediately interrupted, no, you can't. He will find you soon. It was obvious that she didn't trust this stranger at all. But Ju-won confidently made a judgment, no, he won't come. Or rather, he can't, because only we know about Justice's death. Chami and Haste looked doubtful, what? How do you know that? Ju-won explained, yesterday I told everyone that there was an assassination. But they didn't react to it at all. That means that whoever the assassin is, they thought the assassination failed. These words seemed reasonable, Haste had no objection. She sighed and covered her face with helplessness, then turned and left. Before leaving, she didn't forget to say to Chami angrily. I don't know how long this will last, but you have to clean up his mess. From this reaction, Ju-won thought he was hated, but Chami explained. Don't worry about her, she is the best assistant among Justice's heroes. This situation is too complicated for her. To be honest, the Protectors are the only group of real heroes left. They stayed for Justice, but if Justice disappeared, they would leave. If that happens, they will abuse their hero status. By then they will be no different from thugs, just stronger. Therefore, we need to do what is necessary. Let them become true heroes again. Let the people trust in the heroes. Ju-won now understood the reason for keeping Justice's death a secret. He didn't expect the problem to be so big, Ju-won smiled and confidently declared. Don't worry, didn't you see me fooling everyone yesterday, right? Let's move forward, see I'm right, right? Chami didn't care much at the moment because she had to rearrange the upcoming plans. And coincidentally, today the two of them had an important task to do. The task was to go to lunch. Ju-won just needed to sit and have lunch and he could attract a lot of people around him. Because the rumor that Justice was almost assassinated had spread widely, Ju-won needed to appear publicly more as Justice to reassure the public. And another special reason was because today was Hero OT. Ju-won didn't know what day it was, so Chami pointed to the rookies and explained. Every 3 months, there will be new heroes recruited. It was a big event in adding more forces. And it also decided which group they would join among the four groups. Like the way clubs recruit members among the first-year college students. Although it was more important, it was similar. After quickly slurping a bowl of noodles, Chami led Ju-won to the event venue. It was a huge stadium with countless seats around. Ju-won witnessed this scene for the first time and was so amazed that he couldn't close his mouth. Chami saw that and hurriedly reminded him, "Close your mouth. We can't show a Justice in worry." Just the appearance of Justice alone attracted a lot of attention from the other heroes. This made Ju-won a little worried. "I didn't think it would be so big. It seems like there are more heroes than in the last meeting, now tell me what to do." Ju-won still doesn't know what he has to do here. But Chami told him he didn't have to do anything. Seeing Ju-won's stupid face, Chami continued, "The best person doesn't have to do anything. Just sit in the center and look serious." This seems more boring than what Ju-won expected. He looked around and found that the number of people in the other groups was more than the guards. Chami explained that in terms of numbers, the guards would be at a disadvantage. At that moment, Haste came and sat next to Ju-won. Ju-won hesitated and asked, "Do you really want to sit here?" Haste coldly replied, "Don't delude yourself anymore. Even if I sit here, I don't think I like you." Ju-won just wanted to punch her for being angry. But because he couldn't beat her, he could only curse in his heart. "Does she think I want to? Was Justice's death my fault? What the hell is wrong with her?" At that moment, the program announcement began. The first will be a battle between two rookies, one with pink hair and one with brown hair. Both are very confident in their abilities and want to show off in front of the team leaders. The match just started, the brown-haired guy wrapped his fist in dirt and stone and rushed to attack. The pink-haired guy dodged lightly and counterattacked with an energy beam from his palm. The two then clashed repeatedly. Ju-won watched and wondered, why are they suddenly fighting? Chami explained, "As I said, this is the OT meeting, they are showing off to attract the teams." Ju-won thought this was just a friendly match, but the next scene made him horrified. The pink-haired youth did not stop after defeating his opponent. He pinned his opponent to the ground like a beast and kept attacking his injured arm. Ju-won saw this and immediately stood up to intervene. But he was stopped by Chami, who said, "I told you not to do anything." Ju-won asked back, "What? You want me to just watch?" Even though he was going too far, Chami was adamant. He said, "This is just a normal fight and the power of different factions. And he did not do anything illegal, so you have no reason to stop him. Even if you are Justice, you can't." The pink-haired youth was enjoying torturing his opponent brutally. He said, "Why don't you raise your hand and surrender? If not, your arm will be crushed. I will spare you if you know your place." "Oh, or is it because I'm pinning you down that you can't raise your hand? Let me see how I can disable your arm." At that moment, a hand reached out to stop him. It was obvious who it was. Hester and Chami were also helpless with Ju-won's action. The reason for this was very simple. Ju-won always wanted to be a hero like his sister's image. Always doing justice and stopping evil. Ju-won could not stand this unheroic action, so he intervened. Everyone almost trusted the heroes. But he was here laughing and hurting another hero. Didn't he feel weird? The other heroes were buzzing about it. Justice had never acted like this before. The pink-haired youth still did not know fear. He said, "Hey, what are you doing? Why are you interfering? Is it because he is one of the protectors?" Ju-won calmly explained. "He doesn't need to be harsh with the other heroes, right? I'm just telling him his limits." The pink-haired youth smirked contemptuously. "Oh my, what will you do if I don't comply? He concentrated energy in his palm and aimed straight at Juwon. He was very confident in his ability. He could rely on his push and pull power. "Because you dare to keep that power glove, you idiot, I will make you lose face and create a laughingstock for the audience." Damn, this kid never watches the news, does he? He dares to talk back to the top one hero. Juwon only needs to gently grab his wrist and he will be in so much pain that he can't do anything. All he needs to do is raise his right hand and surrender, or he can choose not to. The pink-haired youth now becomes the one who suffers. He keeps screaming but can't surrender. At that moment, Jiyoung appeared and intervened. "Should you get involved in a fight like this? If you want to fight so much, then fight with someone who is on the same level as you," Jiyoung said and then released a huge source of blood-red energy. Juwon was hit by this attack and had to step back a few steps. The other heroes saw this and became excited. The battle between the two top heroes would surely go down in history. Haste was very worried at this time, but if she interfered, things would only get worse. Chami understood why Haste was worried. It was not strange that Haste acted like that. Currently, Li Juwon can hardly control the power of justice. He was only good at releasing power and even worse when his opponent was Jiyoung. Juwon knew his own strength well and decided to make peace. "Jiyoung, we don't have to fight here." But Jiyoung didn't let it go easily. "You're wrong. What will happen to my pride if I keep backing down and you keep pushing forward? I won't allow that to happen. There's no other way." Juwon had to fight this battle. He emitted a huge amount of energy and attacked first. But his fist was easily blocked by Jiyoung. "Wow, you're pretty strong. It seems like you really want to fight, huh? But it looks like you don't know anything." Juwon's strength was being drained from his body continuously. It was obviously Jiyoung's power. He concentrated the large amount of energy he absorbed in front of his fist and returned it to Juwon. Juwon quickly used both hands to defend against the attack, but he also felt a bit overwhelmed. His arms were numb and he didn't know how many more hits he could take. Juwon had some doubts about Jiyoung's strength, so he took the initiative to attack again. But no matter how hard he punched, Jiyoung still stood still and didn't take any damage. Not only that, he also counterattacked with a huge amount of energy. At this point, Juwon confirmed his suspicion. "I had wondered about this, but Jiyoung really wanted to fight me with his own strength. Well, to be strict, this wasn't the main character's strength, right?" Jiyoung smiled mockingly after a series of attacks. "What's wrong with you? This is not like you. It's pathetic." He used the huge amount of energy that he absorbed to attack Juwon again. Juwon now only knew how to defend passively. "If you attack, your energy will also be drained and become useless." The other hero saw Justice being overwhelmed and discussed excitedly. They were very surprised that the number one hero could not do anything in a solo battle like this. Only Chami understood the situation best, he was overwhelmed naturally. Because Jiyoung was the owner of the absorption power. He absorbed all kinds of attacks and used them. No matter how hard he hit Jiyoung, he would always respond with the same strength. If he continued like this, it would be a humiliating defeat. After attacking non-stop, Jiyoung also stopped and provoked. "Why don't you keep attacking? You are really the pride of the protectors, the strongest hero, Justice." These words provoked the heroes who were watching. No one thought that the number one hero would only defend. Juwon was very panicked at this time. "Damn, they were all talking about me. I acted wrongly because I was too excited about becoming a hero. I could easily make money if I listened to Chami. But if they could act like that because they had power, I could also stop them with this power." Juwon once again rushed to attack, this time Jiyoung also actively rushed to suck his energy and counterattack. "It seems like he is planning something, don't try to use your power anymore, it will be useless." But before he could finish his sentence, he was overwhelmed by the huge power of Juwon. Facing such a massive energy source, Jiyoung could hardly absorb it all. Juwon was full of enthusiasm at this moment. "I want to be a great hero like Justice no matter what. I will release so much power that he won't be able to absorb it." Jiyoung was a bit overloaded now, he was using all his strength to resist the huge energy of Juwon. The pressure of this battle was so terrifying that it blew everything around and reached the stands. It was difficult to observe the battle alone. Chami witnessed this scene and was extremely amazed, he couldn't believe it. At first he had difficulties, but now Jiyoung was almost unable to keep up. "If they don't stop, everything will go to hell because of a friendly match. Jiyoung won't be able to take it." In the decisive moment, suddenly there was an invisible pressure that made them both stop. Juwon's body became extremely heavy and hard to move. That was the power of Arcadia. "What are you doing? Do you want to destroy everything? End it all." Arcadia then flicked his hand, and the invisible pressure disappeared. The battle also ended with that, but no one gave in. Juwon now felt regretful for his reckless action. At that moment, the young man who was beaten up before and after bandaging came to thank him. "Justice, it happened because of me. I'm too ashamed to show my face. Thank you for your help." Not only that, but many other heroes also praised Juwon's recent action. They also thought it was the right thing to do that the heroes should follow. Juwon also felt happier after this. It turned out that the ideal of heroism that he pursued was correct. The next day, Chami came to Juwon and brought along a table of the number of heroes participating in each group. Although Juwon's action for justice could prevent a tragedy from happening, it was a failure of the group of protectors. The number of new members joining this year's group was even worse than last year. Juwon looked at it and was a bit puzzled by the large difference between the groups. Haste quickly explained to him. "Our heroes are not only losing, but with the current criminal force being very low, there are not many people who want to join the group of protectors. If this continues, we will be taken over by Uberman, who has more influence." Juwon still didn't understand much after hearing that. "It seems like a big problem, doesn't it?" Chami had to explain further. "Did you forget what kind of team Uberman is? As long as they have money, they will even support the criminals. It is a completely talent-based system. What do you think will happen if a group has full power in Archie?" Juwon thought for a while and then asked, "Why don't we form an alliance?" Chami continued, "Even if we do that, who do we do it with? And Kondo is too extreme. Union only thinks about the benefits and doesn't need to talk about Uberman. Union may have some potential, but it won't be that simple. Unless we have someone on the inside." Hearing this, Juwon spoke up, "Huh, what? If so, it's very easy." He took out his phone and pressed it repeatedly. "It might be a bit troublesome to do two people at the same time, but as a mole, I will do the job for 2 billion. Damn, this guy was blinded by money. That night, Chami took Juwon to the roof of a building and watched a pool party. When Juwon wondered why he came here, Chami explained, "Wyndham, he ranks third in the Union. In the Union, heroes are ranked by fame. Although they rarely act like other heroes, they organize parties daily, so they have quite a few networks. Today, the planned vote will take place in the Union, so Wyndham will definitely participate." Juwon, after hearing this, smiled confidently. "I just need to manipulate the vote, right?" Chami, having some doubts, asked again, "Are you really okay? Any plans?" At this moment, Juwon looked towards a girl and confidently asserted, "Well, not to brag, but everyone has their own secrets." After a while, Wyndham arrived at the party with his escort. It seems like he drank quite a bit and was a bit tipsy. He stirred up the party and began to enjoy the pleasure of tonight. The escort, seeing this, reminded him, but it seemed like he didn't care much. Right at this moment, a girl walked up and unfortunately spilled wine on Wyndham. Wyndham, about to scold, then noticed that it was a beautiful redhead, so he immediately changed his attitude. "It's okay, little sister, things like this happen frequently at parties." The redhead girl gently touched Wyndham's chest and whispered, "No, I want to clean it up for you, somewhere quieter." With a mindset as straightforward as Wyndham's, he would undoubtedly not refuse this request. He instructed the escort to keep watch here and went with the beautiful girl to enjoy themselves. After entering the room, while Wyndham was preparing, he was suddenly knocked unconscious on the spot. It turned out that this girl was transformed by Juwon. After successfully breaking in, Juwon started looking for the tablet conference. After a while of searching, he finally found it. "Here it is, eye and fingerprint recognition, huh?" He looked like that but still paid attention to the tablet security. Thank God it didn't have a password. With his power, Juwon easily unlocked the tablet and joined the conference. The host of the conference was Arcadia, who was a bit surprised to see Wyndham join.
Wyndham, why are you early today?
Wait, should I thank you for joining?" To avoid being exposed, Juwon only texted that he was at a party. Arcadia didn't doubt anything.
"Anyway, you know what we're voting for this time, right? At the upcoming meeting? We need to decide whether to work with the group of protectors or not. Based on the number of votes, we will decide based on the opinion of the whole union. Let's decide by the number of votes." According to the popularity ranking, Wyndham ranked third and had 985 votes. Seeing this ranking made Juwon sigh. "That's crazy, voting based on popularity, huh? This is not a game show, Union has a weird way of doing things." But thanks to Wyndham's votes, Juwon had a chance to change the voting result. After the voting ended, only Arcadia could know the result and he seemed surprised. "The result is a bit surprising, but whatever, everyone disperse. We will act according to the result, just know that." Looking at Arcadia's astonished expression, Juwon also guessed the result. He breathed lightly and turned back to normal. After arriving at the meeting point, Chami asked Juwon how it went.
"Just as expected," Juwon smiled brightly. "Of course, I proved that I'm worth 2 billion.
On the other hand, Wyndham didn't remember anything after waking up. But he still insisted to the escort that he had attended the meeting and voted. What he regretted now was that he didn't get to ask for the girl's number yesterday. The escort thought for a long time and then spoke up. "Hey Wyndham, please give me the list of all the people you invited yesterday." It seemed like he had discovered something wrong. The next day, Ju-won returned to his old house to clean up his belongings. Because he had to pretend to be justice for a while longer, he needed to bring along the necessary items. Hester seemed unhappy but had to accept it anyway. While cleaning the closet, Ju-won accidentally found the family photo again. He had always wondered where it had gone, but he didn't expect it to be here. Looking at the old photo, Ju-won suddenly fell into a deep thought. His sister would be very happy if she knew that her brother had become justice. Ju-won was about to take the photo out to put it away, but he accidentally used too much force and broke the frame. The photo then fell under the bed. To get the photo out, Ju-won decided to lift the bed up a little bit. But how the hell did he just push it lightly and the bed flew up to the ceiling? Ju-won was stunned at this point, clearly he hadn't turned into Justice yet. After returning to Justice's apartment, Ju-won immediately told Chami what he had gone through. To prove it, Ju-won picked up a metal pen and easily crushed it into pieces with two fingers. Seeing this, Chami made a conclusion. "It seems that you are using Justice's power unconsciously or the power is self-activated. Power is like muscles, the more you use them, the stronger they become. Even more so for a rookie. At first, you thought you only copied his power, right? Well, it might have more potential than we expected. Although I really want to test more, Ju-won now needs to focus on the task at hand." He turned into Justice and started an important meeting. Because Arcadia had to go on a long business trip, this meeting would be held online. As soon as it started, Nivelle spoke first, "Let's get started. Anyway, today there is only one issue, right? But it seems that we have discussed it before, right at this moment," Arcadia interrupted. "About that, Union will protect the position of the protectors." Nivelle was very astonished and shouted. "What? But why so suddenly?" Arcadia explained, "As you may know, we decided by voting. The voting result was that we should focus on hunting down the remaining villains. As a leader, I will respect the opinions from the members of the team." Nivelle was very angry with this opinion. He thought he could hold the protectors in his palm. At this time, Russ, who was fighting with the criminals, also spoke up. "Nivelle, I really don't understand why you are against catching criminals. Is there any reason for you to oppose it?" Nivelle heard and yelled. "We destroyed the base of the criminals in the final battle. This only wastes our human resources." Ju-won spoke up at this time, "I don't think that's right. It seems that the number has decreased significantly, but there will soon be more criminals appearing again. Even though the leader of them disappeared, rooting them out is the way to avoid trouble in the future." The others agreed with this opinion and turned to criticize Nivelle. Nivelle was very angry but didn't know how to argue back. At that moment, Jiang showed up. "Enough Nivelle, if everyone agrees then what can we do? Anyway, cleaning up the criminals is good for us. We can't win the votes as villains. So, during this time we will follow the position of the protectors." And that's how the meeting ended well. Thanks to the spy plan, the protectors could still continue to operate. Ju-won then went back home with Chami to clean up the mess that he caused. The ceiling had a big hole and the bed was completely broken. Ju-won would have to pay money to fix this. But now he is rich so he doesn't need to worry. When Chami was about to leave, he suddenly saw a stranger standing in front of the door. That was the person who escorted Wyndham at the party. "I recognize you. You are the hero Chami from the Protectors, right? I didn't think I would meet you in a place like this." Although he smiled very brightly, Chami didn't show any happiness when he met him. "I came to see someone I know." "What are you doing here, Stiletto?" Stiletto suddenly became serious. "Someone you know? Lee Ju-won, 23 years old. He has the ability to copy others, right?" Ju-won was startled when he saw his information exposed. At this point, Stiletto laughed and continued. "An interesting power. But I just don't understand one thing. Why did you come to the party yesterday?" Ju-won immediately denied. "I don't understand what you're saying." But Stiletto interrupted right away. "Don't stubbornly deny it. I watched the surveillance camera nearby. You approached Wyndham with the appearance of a woman and left a while later. The footage was very clear." Ju-won didn't expect this. He had no other way but to make up a reason. "You know me. I'm actually a fan of Wyndham. So I wanted to cause him some trouble. But who would believe such a clumsy reason like this? Your blatant lie, how should I say it? It's annoying. You turned into a girl to cause trouble for Wyndham. So who are you trying to cause trouble for by turning into Justice? I'm not sure. But I have an interesting hypothesis." The atmosphere immediately became tense. Stiletto spat out one of his teeth and threw it forward. Juwon was still clueless about what was going on when Chami was captured by a giant tooth. Stiletto's current goal is to extract all the necessary information from Juwon's mouth, even if he has to kill him if necessary. He grew a large and sharp bone from his palm to use as a weapon. Juwon was confused and shouted, "What are you doing?" Stiletto did not attack immediately but calmly explained, "I told you, I need to verify some things. I think Justice has been acting very strangely lately." He revealed the assassination plot, but there was still something very weird. "And now Justice's close friend, Chami, is with a shapeshifter. You are really suspicious." As soon as he finished speaking, Stiletto rushed up with murderous intent. He really thought about killing Juwon here, so he aimed at all the vital points. Fortunately, Juwon had been fighting continuously for the past few days, so he had trained a bit of reflex. Did he know that he had almost lost his head several times these days? Why do these heroes keep messing with his life? Stiletto was still jumping around. "I think you impersonated Justice, right?" Juwon was completely annoyed. His whole body emitted a huge amount of power without having to transform into Justice. "That sounds like crap." Stiletto was a bit surprised by this power, but he still had no intention of leaving. "Oh, I don't think you will easily tell the truth. I will make you tell everything." His whole body emitted a strong killing intent, and his other hand also grew a bone. After confirming the opponent's ability, Juwon made a decision. The assassination of Justice might not have been done by him, so it was not a problem. If he obediently admitted it, his 2 billion would disappear in a blink of an eye. Juwon did not hesitate and attacked, but his fist was easily repelled by Stiletto. "Your power is not bad, but it has a lot of flaws. Are you using Justice's power to stop me with those cat tricks? You are too arrogant. If you keep using your power in such a weak way to hide it, you will surely die." Stiletto had no intention of holding back and aimed straight at Juwon's head. Juwon managed to block with both hands, but he was pressed down to the ground, unable to move. In a dangerous situation, he tried to use his legs to attack the opponent and escape. Juwon quickly grabbed the opponent's wrists, hoping to lock the attacks from the two sharp bones. Stiletto was still calm. Instead of calling it hiding power, it seemed like he didn't know how to show it. His body was very weak, so it craved power, it wanted authority to lead others. Power is related to human desires. "I can't believe you use power without thinking and without basic knowledge like that. Don't you see that your power is being wasted? Do you think you can stop me from using the bones in my hands? That's not the only place to attack." As soon as he finished speaking, two huge bones sprouted from his elbows and pierced Juwon's head. Juwon had no choice but to let go and dodge. But he quickly hugged Stiletto and rushed forward. Not letting the opponent react, Juwon grabbed his head and slammed it hard on his knee. But because the opponent had put on thorny armor, the one who got hurt was him. "Do you know what is the hardest part of human bones? The answer is the skull." Stiletto had created a hard bone mask that covered his entire face, so he was not injured at all. Juwon was holding his thigh in pain, his face had no wounds. Maybe he was telling the truth, "Until now I was just struggling to not get caught. While I only thought it was bad luck, but myself, who couldn't do anything and would give up even a little difficulty, I hated myself very much. Until I got this power, what the hell am I doing?" Juwon was so focused on thinking that he didn't notice Stiletto approaching him closely. He only woke up when he spoke. Even though Juwon's body was stronger than before, victory was impossible. There was only one way to use it at this time. Juwon used all his strength to punch forward. Stiletto not only avoided this blow, but also pressed his sharp bone against Juwon's neck. But Juwon's goal from the beginning was not him, but to free Chami, who was being held captive. "If we can't beat him solo, then we'll gang up on him." As soon as Chami escaped, he immediately controlled the shadow to tie up Stiletto. "Thanks for the advice, but because you locked me in that sticky tooth, I'm angry now, so you better prepare yourself, bone man." After struggling for a while without any results, Stiletto calmed down again. "So that's it, you really know how to trick others, huh? But I told you, didn't I? They don't work on my hands." He grew two sharp bones and tore Chami's shadow, then attacked immediately. Chami didn't defend passively, but chose to attack actively. She controlled the shadow to turn into sharp spikes and attacked from a distance. But these things didn't cause any significant damage to Stiletto. He broke his bone and threw it hard forward. Luckily, Chami avoided it, or he would have been pierced. Stiletto took advantage of that opportunity to approach and grab Chami, but failed. Chami went into the shadow and teleported behind him. Both of them exchanged blows and didn't give in to each other. Witnessing the battle of the experts made Juwon gasp in astonishment. It was amazing, they were evenly matched. After a while of fighting, Stiletto slowed down his attack and thought of a change of strategy. After calculating Chami's attack style, he came up with a countermeasure. Stiletto pulled out two teeth and threw them at Chami. Just like before, the two teeth exploded and flew to wrap around the target. But one trick couldn't hit twice. Chami used the shadow to deflect the trajectory of the two teeth. But at that moment, Stiletto disappeared from her sight. When she realized, he had approached and prepared to attack. Even though Chami tried to use the shadow to defend, it was too late. She took both knees to the body and was knocked away. Not stopping there, Stiletto continued to rush up. Chami just landed and stabbed straight at the opponent with the whip. But unfortunately, all the whips were blocked by the bones. Stiletto broke each whip and moved forward. Chami thought of a new trick and applied it immediately. She gathered the shadow into a giant beast with sharp teeth biting the opponent. She thought she had dealt with the opponent, but things weren't that easy. Stiletto took advantage of the dust of the slash and touched the ring behind Chami's back. When he was about to act, Chami suddenly said, "Stop, we are alike." Stiletto then realized that his neck was about to be pierced from behind and decided to stop. Chami saw that and continued, "Have you stopped? Anyway, you didn't mean to attack me, right? Before throwing teeth at me, you could have thrown them at me, but you deliberately missed. That's enough, tell me what your plan is?" Stiletto calmly answered. "This is just a previous guess, but the assassination plot that Justice announced at the hero meeting was clearly a failure, but Justice was assassinated. This is the video of you turning into Justice. I had to work hard to find it. If it is revealed, the replacement of Justice will also be exposed immediately." As soon as he finished speaking, Stiletto destroyed the USB right away. "But I think standing on their side is not too bad, we are similar. I can be a member of the Union, but I am also like you, a spy from Ankondo. Right now the Protectors and Ankondo are being left behind by Union and Uberman. But they care more about benefits than eliminating criminals. So, I infiltrated the Union to create chaos from within. I need teammates to help me plan and will not betray. Right, the three of us will go into Union and reverse the situation. Fuck, fighting to death all day long turns out to be comrades with the same direction." Chami heard it but still couldn't trust. "How can I be sure that's all the evidence you have? What if you turn your back?" Stiletto smiled and shrugged indifferently. "Trust me or not is your choice. But I like your ability, it will be useful for many things. Well, if you don't want to, you can refuse. But I still have work to do at Union. If you don't follow my side, you will have to face me. And I'm sure you won't beat me." Before this threat, Chami only thought he was too confident. She believed she could win if she fought seriously. Juwon spoke up at this moment. "Wait, do you understand the situation? Yes, I am the replacement for Justice. So I have to find the suspect who killed him. And if you follow us, you might get involved in this too. Do you mean you don't care about that?" Stiletto was excited to hear this. "That's right, and then I'll get to kill the villain who killed Justice, right? That sounds reassuring. Those Ankondo guys are really crazy. But that's why Juwon felt he could trust this person." After clarifying the views of both sides, Stiletto asked the two about their final decision. Chami and Juwon looked at each other hesitantly. They both understood the difficult situation right now. After a while of thinking, Juwon stepped forward and asked, "All right, let's talk a bit. Do you have a plan?" Stiletto smiled dangerously at this point. The next day, at the headquarters of Union, Juwon successfully passed the door thanks to the fake hero identity that he worked hard to make last night. Juwon was quite overwhelmed by the scene here. It was completely different from the place of the Protectors. Here people dress normally and look very comfortable. At this moment, Chami spoke up to explain. "That's because Union is a group that leans towards commerce, so there is no specific regulation on clothing." Seeing Chami in casual clothes made Juwon stare. "I just want to say that you are really beautiful." Chami suddenly got praised and turned her face. "What are you talking nonsense for? Disgusting." Juwon hurriedly explained. "I mean, you always look gloomy and dark. I also find it strange, so I can't help it." Chami blushed and urged Juwon to follow her to change the topic. On the way, Juwon suddenly recognized a famous food streamer who registered to give fans. It seems that she is preparing to become a hero to increase her followers. Union is indeed a place where heroes come to do business. At this time, Stiletto came to greet the two people enthusiastically. The three then discussed the plan at a safe place. At a glance, the plan seemed fine. The three would increase their popularity at Union to be able to vote. This place does not care about experience and talent, as long as they can attract the attention of everyone. Juwon wondered, but Chami came from the Protectors and she would surely be suspected. How to increase her popularity at Union? Stiletto just smiled and said that there would be a way. In a class, a professional hero was teaching the rookies. "Everyone already knew, our power was based on manifestation. Based on manifestation, you can use your power in many ways. But sometimes manifestation will not go in the right direction. Usually this will happen when the power has just appeared. People with power will mostly always lose control of their power at that time and will lead to a state of madness and violence. Users in a state of madness and violence will lose their sanity and have a dangerous source of power within them. And the hero will be the one to appear and suppress them. If anyone is interested in this topic, I can help you register for the professional training course. The rookies were buzzing after hearing it. Us? Doing such a dangerous mission? It sounds like dying in a useless way. The lecturer was already too familiar with this scene. As I thought, there was no newcomer who volunteered to go. Not to mention this is the Union, not Ankondo or the Protectors. After waiting for a while without anyone saying anything, the lecturer decided to continue the lesson. At that moment, a hand suddenly raised. Wait, can my group join? The lecturer was very surprised to see this. He hadn't seen a rookie so enthusiastic for a long time. But the other rookies reacted differently. Hey, are you crazy? Did you ask your group members first? Ju-won just smiled awkwardly and turned to ask Stiletto. Are you sure it will be okay? Everyone is buzzing about it. Stiletto calmly replied. It's fine. This will be hard for newcomers, but for someone with the power of justice, it's as easy as pie. Ju-won could only trust these words, not knowing what to do. For the rest of the class, he looked into the distance with a longing gaze, thinking about his upcoming hero life. At the end of the class, Chami took Ju-won to the training place. This was the training place of justice, although Haste also used it. So, why did you want me to prepare this place? Ju-won answered quickly. It's because of the difference in power. You see, when I beat Kasar, I just used my power as I pleased. And the match with Ankondo too, if the fight lasted longer, I would definitely lose. Stiletto was right, until now, I only knew how to make money and spend money. But then, Ju-won's arm was gradually changing in a weird way, the fairy energy wrapped around his arm as if it wanted to burst out. Ju-won's mind was remembering the past. On his sister's birthday when Ju-won was 18 years old, his family had a picnic outside. That day, Ju-won gave his sister a wonderful birthday gift with his power. He turned into the appearance of the absolute hero, the one that his sister admired. The party atmosphere was filled with joy and happiness, but then disaster struck. A giant criminal flew in from nowhere and crushed Ju-won's parents into a pulp. The criminal had a bizarre shape and looked at the two siblings and made a sound. He found the hero, Ju-won was stiff and did not dare to move. He was wearing the hero's armor, but he had no fighting power at all. He could only wait for death. But the cry of his sister woke Ju-won up. He gathered all his courage and rushed towards the criminal. But with just one slap, Ju-won was thrown into the wall and returned to normal. He then could only watch helplessly as his sister was bitten by the criminal. That scene haunted Ju-won until now. That was the reason he was determined to use the power of justice in the right way. Back to the present, Ju-won's arm was swollen with a huge amount of energy concentrated. With just one punch, a series of walls in front collapsed into small pieces. Chami witnessed this scene and was amazed and speechless. She could not believe that Ju-won had changed so much in a short period of time. Meanwhile, in a secret place, a mysterious person was typing furiously. It seemed that he had discovered a secret in Union. Just then, a phone call came to announce that someone was coming here. The mysterious young man was very happy to hear that. He got up and walked to the iron door nearby. He left behind a blinking substance wherever he went. As soon as he opened the door, the whole space echoed with screams. This place was full of monstrous and bloodthirsty creatures. It seems like something bad is about to happen. The next day, the three-person team of Ju-won, Chami, and Stiletto started their patrol mission. Ju-won was still uneasy about this action. But then, the person with superpowers who was in a berserk state seemed dangerous. We will be fine, right? But Stiletto was very relaxed. We have Chami and Justice here, what are we worried about? Actually, because Chami went with them, they did not send another veteran hero there. That was very risky. Chami immediately asked. Isn't there four people in the group? Who is the fourth member? We can't just pick anyone. As soon as he mentioned it, that person appeared. It turned out to be the famous streamer on Yumi. She seemed very happy and friendly with her teammates. But Chami questioned Stiletto right away. Why did you bring a celebrity along? What the hell were you thinking? Stiletto explained with a smile. I told you, the members of the Union are also equal to celebrities. Having on Yumi as a representative for the group is great, especially when we need to hide our identity. On Yumi was attracted by the mention of hiding identity. Ju-won was very worried that the plan would be exposed. But it seemed like he was worrying too much. On Yumi was carefree like a fairy. I know, everyone probably broadcasts on the internet, right? I understand. I was like that when I first started. It's a bit inconvenient to reveal your face in public. The whole group suddenly felt relieved after hearing that. Then, the team split into two groups to search in a wider area. Jiwon was hoping to go with Chami, but he was assigned to go with An Yumi. Jiwon went to Stiletto and said, "Why? What are you plotting?" Stiletto calmly explained. "Do you still remember the teacher's explanation about the transformation? You haven't been able to do it yet, right? Your power before and after the transformation is very different. An Yumi will help you with that. I'm sure it will be easier for you to observe and learn from someone like her. And if you still doubt me, Chami can watch over you, right?" Jiwon was very surprised after hearing these words. He didn't expect someone harmless like An Yumi to help him control his power. But Chami agreed with the team division plan immediately. After that, the two groups separated and searched around. On the way, Jiwon was still curious about the team division issue. He kept looking at An Yumi and evaluated her appearance as fatter than on the internet. To divert his attention from this issue, Jiwon asked about Yumi's ability. An Yumi didn't hide it and answered cheerfully. "I can eat as much as I want and then I will become stronger. What kind of power is that vague?" Jiwon continued to ask An Yumi why she wanted to be a hero. An Yumi peeled a cake and answered. "Because I want to be a famous streamer while eating everything I want. I'm promoting my stream right now." But that's not what Jiwon wanted to ask. "I mean, what's the reason for you to use your power?" An Yumi answered without thinking. "Nothing at all. Do we have to have a reason?" Jiwon was full of question marks in his head. "Wait, that old man said she would help me transform, right? Is that dislep stiletto guy playing with me?" An Yumi continued. "Just think about what you want to do. It doesn't have to be anything fancy." These words helped Jiwon think a little clearer. "What I want to do." This simple-minded girl had a clearer idea of why she used her power than I did. At that moment, An Yumi discovered something. It looked like a person with superpowers who was in a berserk state. The goal of the whole group was to subdue these people before they went crazy and caused damage. Since they hadn't been discovered yet, Jiwon decided to approach them quietly. But suddenly there was a noise behind him. It turned out that An Yumi had pulled out a bunch of chocolate and chewed on it. Jiwon was extremely horrified. "Oh my god. Do you use your brain at all?" He immediately ran over and grabbed An Yumi's hand and told her to stop. But it was too late, the two of them had caught the attention of the monster. It went berserk and rushed to tear apart the target in front of it. An Yumi turned on her transformation mood, and all the food she had eaten earlier turned into her power. An Yumi was not afraid and rushed forward to kick the monster away. It turned out that An Yumi would burn her stored calories to get huge strength. That was why she never got fat no matter how much she ate. "I'm sure many of you wish you had this power." The monster knew he was not a match and ran away. An Yumi saw that and immediately chased after him and told Jiwon to contact the others in the team. As Jiwon was taking out his phone, a black puddle suddenly grabbed the phone. Jiwon did not have time to understand what had just happened when the puddle turned into a human. "Computer calling your buddies, huh? It's broken now." The phone was damaged, making Jiwon a bit confused. "We didn't even know there was someone else here." He was still in a stable state of mind, probably not those crazy ones. "But, we have to prioritize reporting to Stiletto and Yumi." Jiwon did not think much and rushed to snatch the phone carelessly. When he was about to punch the phone thief, he turned into mud and avoided it easily. As soon as Jiwon was careless, he approached and stabbed him in the side with a knife. Jiwon immediately reacted and swung his fist straight into the criminal's temple. Although he hit him, he felt something was wrong with his hand. The criminal took a punch to the head but had no problem. He completely despised Jiwon and only paid attention to the girl who had just left. Jiwon was holding his wound and questioning. "Are you related to the violent ones who appeared here?" The criminal sneered. "Yeah, who knows? Maybe I'm the one who helps them turn their desires into reality. You can call me a teacher, right? You see, none of them can change. So I just help them a little so they can change." Jiwon heard this and immediately got into a fighting stance. "You didn't use your power just now because you didn't want to hurt innocent people. But the madman in front of you is definitely not innocent. So maybe I don't need to go easy on him anymore, right?" The criminal sneered and rushed to attack Jiwon. He turned his legs into mud and slid on the ground. When Jiwon attacked him, he turned his hand into mud and pierced through his body. Jiwon's arm touched it and got stuck with a pile of annoying black mud. He didn't have time to react when the criminal attacked again with countless mud bullets. The mud on his arm became sticky and couldn't be removed by force. The criminal saw this and laughed happily. "You can't escape from it, kid. My mud, once it sticks, will be more elastic than rubber. If you try a little more, maybe you can do something. I won't let you escape easily." He said and kept shooting mud from his mouth towards Jiwon. Because there were too many, Ju-won couldn't avoid them all and got hit. He was now in more and more danger, and moving more and more difficultly. If he stayed still like this, he would be in trouble. He had to get close to him. Ju-won immediately rushed to attack before it was too late. But the criminal was very calm. "Oh, you dare to rush at me like that? You can't touch me with that distance, right? But your whole body is covered with mud, are you sure you will be okay?" Ju-won ignored the provocation and focused on attacking. He put his strength into his left arm that could still move and punched the criminal. But how the hell did the criminal not feel any pain and even show a provocative face? Ju-won's arm was stuck in the criminal's body and couldn't budge. The criminal took this opportunity to counterattack. He punched Ju-won's face repeatedly to avenge him. "You thought you would win by getting close, huh?" Unable to endure any longer, Ju-won burst out his power and escaped from the mud on his hand. "You try to block this one." Right at that moment, a muscular criminal with a broken arm suddenly appeared. Ju-won had to withdraw his attack and use both hands to defend. Even so, he was still knocked back quite far and felt a bit dizzy. Despite his appearance, he is still human, right? That bastard made him like this. Even in a dangerous situation, Ju-won was always careful not to hurt innocent people. "If you keep being naive like this, you will suffer in the future." The criminal approached Ju-won and said, "You are not fun at all. I have had many like you, so I don't need you in my collection anymore." Ju-won was very shocked. He didn't expect that there were so many people turned into monsters like that. At this time, many other big, black and smelly monsters appeared and surrounded Ju-won. But the criminal was bored with Ju-won and decided to chase after Yumi. He immediately ordered the monsters to deal with Ju-won. As soon as he finished, the collars on the monsters' necks emitted a huge voltage that made them extremely painful. Stimulated by the pain, they rushed madly towards Ju-won. Ju-won was still worried about On Yumi's safety more than himself. This guy is really begging for God. Under the siege of the monsters, Ju-won was beaten up and couldn't fight back. "You are nothing but a punching bag for them to practice." But the punches gradually helped Ju-won get rid of the mud on his body. When he got rid of all the mud, it was also the time he fought back. Ju-won grabbed the monster's hand, his whole body bulging with veins. Now it's time for him to vent his anger. Finally, the mud fell off completely. "I guess I have to thank you. I still have to go to Anyumi's place, so get the hell out of here." The blue monster got a punch in the mouth and his teeth and lips flew away. Ju-won then fought four by himself. But two hands were hard to fight against eight. These monsters basically didn't know pain or fear. Ju-won knocked one down and was attacked by three others. The one who was knocked down quickly came back and fought again. After a while, Ju-won had to continue to be passive and take hits. Although Ju-won tried to be gentle because after all they were still human. It seemed that if he continued, he would be the one to lose. Meanwhile, On Yumi had easily defeated the monster she was chasing. "Phew, proud of what I did today. I have to tell you about it on my livestream later. But I guess being a rookie and livestreaming about the mission like that is not good. Not to mention the new guy still wasn't comfortable enough to show his face. But, why hasn't anyone come here yet? It's too late." Just then, the criminal who fought with Ju-won chased him to the place. "Thank you, you worked hard. I can't believe you caught him. You're amazing too, huh?" When On Yumi asked him who he was, he smiled and said, "I am also a new rookie hero who joined recently. We were aiming for this guy, but you beat us to it." On Yumi heard this and was smug. This girl was so naive, she believed everything anyone said. The criminal then continued, "More importantly, do you know the black-haired person over there? He seemed to be calling his teammates. I think he said that when I passed by." On Yumi heard this and focused on thinking, while the criminal glanced at the corpse of the monster on the ground. "I didn't expect it to lose like that. Did I overestimate it? Or is it the silly girl?" Just then, On Yumi asked, "Excuse me, can I ask, which group are you from? Looking at your outfit, you are not from the Protectors or Ubermen. You don't have any interest in self-eliminating evil people, so you are not from Ankondo either." The criminal laughed and said, "Oh, I belong to the Union, you don't remember me." But On Yumi immediately denied, "No, I remember everyone from Union. Because remembering everyone is a basic requirement of a streamer. I heard for sure that all the rookies had to attend the OT day. But you weren't there, so I found it a bit strange." It seemed that On Yumi was not as dull as she looked, but quite sharp. The criminal was exposed and decided to act. "Chuckle, I wanted to tease her a bit because she had the face of my type. But this is also fun, should I add her to my collection?" But before he could touch On Yumi, she smashed his arm off. On Yumi did not relax her guard and immediately entered the fighting state. "Touching me like that is no different from a crazy fan who is obsessed. Do you know? Your actions are very suspicious. I was ready to leave as soon as I digested everything, but maybe it's time to go on a diet, huh? The criminal was quite amazed by the strength of this petite girl. His arm was even squashed and flattened against the distant wall. It seemed that he had to fight seriously now. Back on Juwon's side, the bitter battle was still going on. Juwon had not given up hope and wanted to awaken the monsters by physical methods. "Wake up, that mud guy is taking advantage of you." But the only answer he got was, "I'm just hungry." It seemed that the intelligence of these monsters was zero and they only acted like zombies. In a careless moment, Juwon was caught by a monster. But now that he knew that these were just mindless beasts, he could be ruthless. Juwon's whole body exploded with immense power, making the monsters tremble. "I really wanted to try this in real combat, but I had to avoid using it in front of that mud guy. However, I think this is still great. Now I can smash you guys without restraint."